Hello learners, I'm Siba. Now we can move to accounting terms. In this lesson, various accounting terms like transaction, purchases, sales, creditors, debtors, etc. can be studied. Let us move to various terms one by one. What is a transaction? It is an event which involves exchange of some value between two or more entities. Transaction can be cash transaction or credit transaction. Example of various transactions can be incurring expenses, payment to a supplier, receipt of money, purchase of stationery. What do you mean by purchases? This term is used for goods to be dealt in. That is, goods are purchased for resale or for producing finished goods which are meant for sale. So, that can be called as purchases. Purchases is the sum of cash purchases and credit purchases. Sales, another term. Sales are total revenues from goods or services provided to customers. Sales can be cash sales or credit sales. Sundry creditors. Creditors are persons who have to be paid by an enterprise an amount for providing goods and services on credit. Persons from whom goods are purchased on credit are the creditors. Persons who have to pay for goods sold or services rendered or in respect of contractual obligations are known as debtors. Another term you can use is the trade debtor or accounts receivable. Debtors are the persons who have purchased goods on credit from the organization and they have the obligation to pay back money to the organization. What do you mean by sales or revenue? Revenue is the amount received by selling products or providing services to customers. Commission received, interest received, dividends received, rent received can be included as sales, revenue or revenue. What are expenses? Cost incurred by a business in the process of earning revenue is the expense. Expenses are measured by the cost of asset consumed or services used during the accounting period. Various expenses are depreciation, rent, salaries, telephone charges, etc. Income. The difference between revenue and expense is the income. Here is a transaction. Goods costing ₹25,000 were sold for ₹35,000. Here the cost of goods sold is ₹25,000. That is the expense. Sale of goods is made for ₹35,000. That is the revenue. Income is equal to revenue minus expense. That is 35,000 minus 25,000, that is 10,000. Profit of an irregular nature is known as gain. Regularly we will sell goods and during the business process, sales are made regularly and for that the income will come inside the business. That income can be considered as revenue. But profit of an irregular nature is the gain. What is loss? It means something against which the firm receives no benefit. It is a fact that expenses lead to revenue, but losses do not. Example of a loss, theft. Loss by a fire, loss by accident, etc. can be considered as examples of this. Profit is the excess of revenue of a business over its cost. Profit can be gross profit or net profit. Sales minus direct costs will give you gross profit. Gross profit is the difference between sales revenue or the proceeds of goods sold or services provided over its direct cost of goods sold. Net profit is the profit made after allowing all types of expenses. There may be a net loss if the expenses exceed the revenue. Gross profit minus indirect expenses will give you net profit. Expenditure. Spending money or incurring a liability for some benefit or service or property received is called expenditure. Payment of rent, payment of salary, purchase of goods, purchase of machinery, etc. are expenditure. Expenditure can be of two types, revenue expenditure and capital expenditure. Benefit of expenditure which is exhausted within a year can be called as revenue expenditure. Benefit of expenditure which will last for more than 1 year can be capital expenditure. Any money or goods taken away from the business by the proprietor for his personal use or private use can be considered as drawings. Amount invested in the enterprise by the owners is the capital. Paid up share capital in a corporate enterprise is an example of capital. Capital is a liability for every business enterprise. Because the amount invested by the owners are to be paid to the owners at the time of winding up of the company. Assets. Things having certain value inside the business are assets. These are tangible objects or intangible rights owned by the enterprise and carrying probable future benefits. Assets are purchased for business use and not for sale. We have tangible assets and intangible assets, fixed assets and current assets. Tangible items are those which can be touched and their physical presence can be noted or felt. Land, building, plant, machinery, etc. are tangible assets. Intangible rights are those rights which one possesses but cannot see. Copyrights, goodwill, patent rights, etc. are intangible assets. Current assets are those assets which are held for a short period, usually 1 year. Balance of the current asset goes on fluctuating throughout the year. Debtors, bills receivable, cash, etc. can be called as current assets. Those assets which are acquired for a long-term use in the business can be called as non-current asset. Such assets raise the profit-earning capacity of the business enterprise. Expenditure on non-current asset is non-recurring. Land, building, plant, machinery, etc. are non-current assets. And the expenditure on non-current assets is of capital nature. Liability is the financial obligation of an enterprise other than owner's funds. Liability is equal to assets minus capital. Liabilities mean the amount which the business owes to outsiders except the owners. Amount which is owed by the business towards outsiders other than owners can be called as liability. External liability. Liability that is payable to outsiders other than the owners. Internal liability. Liability that is payable to the owners can be called as internal liability. Long-term liabilities are those liabilities which are payable after a long term, generally more than 1 year. Debentures, long-term loans, etc. are examples of long-term liabilities. Short-term liabilities. These are liabilities which are payable within a year. Bills payable, bank overdraft, short-term loans, creditors, etc. are short-term liabilities or current liabilities. Account. It is a summarized record of relevant transactions at one place relating to a particular head. Sales account, purchases account, machinery account, land account, etc. are examples of accounts. It records not only the amount of transaction but also their effect and direction. Stock is the tangible property held by an enterprise for the purpose of sale in the ordinary course of business. There are two types of stock, opening stock and closing stock. Opening stock is the amount of stock at the beginning of the accounting period. It is also known as beginning inventory. In the case of manufacturing concern, closing stock means raw materials, work in progress and finished goods on the closing date. That is, stock that is available on the closing date is known as closing stock. Goods. They refer to items forming part of the stock in trade of an enterprise, which are purchased or manufactured with a purpose of selling. So, goods are the items which are meant for selling, or goods are the products in which an enterprise is dealing. Identify from the statements which I am going to tell whether it can be included as goods or assets. Furniture purchased by Mohan, a dealer in furniture, whether it can be included as a goods or as an asset. He is a furniture merchant, so furniture purchased by him is a goods for that organization. Automobile machine purchased by a workshop for manufacturing products. Machine is purchased, so that machine, whether it can be included as goods or assets. It is an asset. It is purchased for manufacturing other products. So, machine is an asset. Another example, machine purchased by a firm for sale to another mill. So, machine is for sale. So, this machine can be included as goods. Another example, furniture purchased by a stationery shop owner. Stationery shop owner has purchased furniture. So, that is not meant for sale. So, that is an asset. We can study some more terms. One term is receivables. Receivables include the outstanding amount due from others. Sometimes, a debtor may accept a bill of exchange, which is payable after a certain period. Such a bill is known as bills receivable. The term payables include the amounts due to others. Trade creditors, bills payable, etc. can be included as payables. Bills receivable means a bill of exchange accepted by a debtor, the amount of which will be received on the specific date. Bills payable means a bill of exchange, the amount of which will be payable on the specified date. Any transaction in an organization can be called as an event. transactions have documentary evidence, and this transaction will create a change in revenue, expense, asset, liabilities, and capital. Cost, another term. Cost is the amount of expenditure incurred on or is attributed to a specified article or product or activity. Voucher. Voucher is a proof of a business transaction. Cash memo, bill, credit note, debit note, etc. can be vouchers. Some customers are allowed reduction in the price of goods by the business. This is known as discount. We have two types of discount: cash discount and trade discount. Trade discount is a reduction allowed by the seller to the buyer at the time of sale on the list price of goods. Trade discount is allowed on bulk purchases. Trade discount is deducted from the list price and only the balance is accounted. So, trade discount will not be shown in the books of account. Cash discount, another term, it is the deduction allowed by the creditor to the debtor on the amount due by the latter. This concession is given only to those who settle their accounts within a stipulated period. Cash discount encourages prompt settlement of accounts. For the debtor who pays the amount, it is an income. For the creditor, cash discount is an expense. In this lesson, now we have studied various terms like transaction, purchases, sales, creditors, debtors, etc. I hope you understood this very well. Thank you.